Okie dokes. Hey there, folks. Welcome to the Midwest Survival Guide. First, we're going to get some credits going for you. So we got William Morrow and Harper Audio present the Midwest Survival Guide. How we talk, love, work, drink, and eat everything with ranch by Charlie Berens. This is the author. For Grandpa Bob. If all perch go to heaven, it's a little awkward for Grandpa Bob right now. Here's a little note before we begin. Make sure you download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider or go directly to www.harpercollins.com/audio/the Midwest Survival Guide. It contains a glossary, recipes, and more that will be referred to as the enhancement. Introduction, Life in the Midwest. For years as a comedian, I've been touring around telling stories about the greatest place on earth, the Midwest. Wisconsin, Minnesota, Michigan, Iowa, Illinois, Indiana, North Dakota, South Dakota, Ohio, Kansas, Nebraska, and Missouri stick out like a silo in a skyline. As a guy born and raised in Wisconsin, I've had the privilege of witnessing the quirks of the Midwest up close. I'll be honest with you. This is a weird place, but that's what keeps it filled with the world's best-kept secrets. And we can't just keep those secrets buried deep inside, because that's where our feelings go. Rather, like a bag of frozen perch from the bottom of my garage freezer, we must share these secrets with anyone who asks, but especially those who don't. And that's what inspired this book. Throughout my years on stage, I've noticed Midwest audiences like stories about sunken ice shanties and church-sponsored bar crawls. That's expected. We're a unique and close-knit club bound by April snow, wallets lost in cornfields, and lying about the best color jig to catch a walleye so there's more in the lake for the liars. But I never expected this thing would take off across the country. Apparently, there's a big demand for freezer perch. Oddly enough, my Midwest-themed Manwalk Minute character, inspired by the time I spent working in local news, first debuted on stage at the Comedy Store in Los Angeles. During the show, I asked, "Is anyone from the Midwest?" And one guy, who may or may not have had a couple two tree beers, says, "Oh yeah, me. I'm from Manwalk." We had a good back and forth in the bit, so I named the Manwalk Minute series after him. But he wasn't the only Midwesterner to raise his hand that night. Turned out, a quarter of the room in that L.A. comedy club was from the American heartland. So I reawakened my native accent, which I'd spent years trying to remove from my budding journalism career, and delivered local and national news and self-deprecating jokes through the lens of the quintessential Midwesterner. I thought I'd release one video and that would be it. But after the success of the first video, I knew I had to keep making more. At first, I was concerned I wouldn't have enough material, but then I remembered that the Midwest is like an onion. And not just any onion. It's the one you forgot about in the back of the crisper that started to sprout. It's full of layers and complexity. It looks a little funny. It makes you cry sometimes when you pull back those layers. And when you plant it, you get another crisper full of onions for your liverwurst. In other words, the material has been heartfelt, bizarre, and endless. The Manwalk Minute soon turned into a live show and social brand. I released the Midwest album Unthawed with Adam Gruhl from Horseshoes and Hand Grenades, and it topped the bluegrass charts. I collaborated with comedians across the United States, and I even created a beer. Eventually, the fan base grew to millions. In short, I got luckier than a buck that just crossed I-94. I've thought about why Midwest life resonates with the rest of the country, and here's what I came up with. First, because everyone's either from the Midwest or knows someone from the Midwest. Second, because the Midwest has largely been underrepresented, or falsely represented, in pop culture. We've been flown over culturally, and most people only seem to notice us every 4 years when we take an outsized control over the political landscape. In truth, the Midwest is an old, dried-up lake bed just waiting for the dam to break, a complex and diverse region that is empirically, despite what those on the coast might think, more exciting than vanilla extract. And no offense to vanilla extract. Sooner or later, everyone's coming to the Midwest. It's unavoidable. Maybe only for a quick visit, but 40 years can go by quicker than a pike snapping through your monofilament line. like brandy through a supper club. These are the days of our lives. Yes, there's a lot of camouflage here, but at least you can't see it. And where you went to high school usually matters more than where you went to college. And yes, Midwest Nice is a real thing, but it can get pretty treacherous if you don't know what you're doing. And so our guests from the South and the East and the West Coast can sometimes get a little bewildered. That's why I've assembled this official guide to the Midwest, a collection of how-tos, tall tales, vocab lessons, etiquette, and advice that gives you everything you need to know about living your best life in America's heartland. I'd call this guide an ode to my favorite region in the world, with its cornflake casserole, quick trips, and hours spent finding ways to leave someone's house politely. Other than my years traveling the country as a newscaster and a stand-up comedian, I've spent my whole life in America's heartland. I've walked across Lambeau Field with my dad, drunk beers on water skis, and woken up at 4 a.m. to enjoy a balmy 15-degree day sitting in a deer stand, only to see more deer taunting me as they cross the highway on my ride home. When someone asks me if I want to drive 45 minutes to a Friday fish fry, there's only one answer, perch or walleye. I've milked cows and goats. I've drilled holes in the ice to fish and drink beer. When someone says I have something nice, my instinct is to tell them I bought it with a coupon. When my first girlfriend said she loved me for the first time, I hesitated and just told her, watch out for deer. This book is at its core a tribute to life in the American Midwest, the good, the bad, and the Chicago Bears. The point of the Manga Minute has always been to make people laugh. At themselves, and at another way of life. And whether online or during our live shows, my hope has always been to bring people together. When everyone is laughing, we forget about what divides us. For years, people have asked me what it was like growing up and living in the middle of America. The Midwest Survival Guide will answer that question, but the short answer is, it's a trade-off. Yes, it gets cold enough that our lakes freeze for months, but how else would we ice fish? Yes, there are biblical swarms of mosquitoes, but without mosquitoes, there'd be fewer hummingbirds. Brutal winters make for euphoric springs. In many ways, the inherent attitude of the Midwest is something the rest of the world may want to borrow. Find joy in the lows of life, because the lows lead to the highs. Fully embrace the good and the bad. Don't be afraid of discomfort. Joke about it. Sure, the weather is better in California, but I guarantee you they'll never appreciate the sunshine like we do. Okie dokes, let's keep her moving. How well do you know the Midwest? Before we begin, let's see how much you already know with a little quiz. At this stage, could be a lot or next to nothing, but no matter how you do, you're a winner. If you're a newbie who bought this book to learn, it'll be a fun exercise to reveal all the great things you'll soon be discovering. And if you nail every question, this quiz proves you're among family here and should enjoy this celebration of all things Midwest. 1. How do you show someone in the Midwest you love them? A. You say, I love you. B. You clean their gutters. C. You say, watch out for deer. Answer, B or C. 2. Your neighbor's lawn has been taken over by dandelions. These people are A, busy, B, botanists, or C, deeply, deeply troubled. Answer, A. 3. Your mom tells you she's just had the most amazing three-way. How do you respond? Wait, what? What in the name of Sam Hill is wrong with you? B, well, aren't you just full of surprises? C, so jealous. Wish I'd been there with you. Answer, C. 4. How many schools are in the Big Ten? A, 10. B, 8. C, 14, obviously. Answer, C. 5. Lake effect snow is A, when snow looks like a lake. B, the name of an indie trap folk duo from Cleveland. C, lake precipitation causing increased snowfall. Answer, C. 6. You have the left and the right. You should A. Go straight down the center. B. Trust your partner for one trick. C. Be cool and give one of them back. Answer, B. This is a euchre question. 7. Ranch dressing is best used on A. Salads. B, pizza. C, yes. Answer, C. 8. A bubbler is A, something used once in Colorado and forgot the question. B, a delivery device for water. C, the poorly parented child in front of you at the Brewers game. Answer, B. 9. Which of these is not people food? A, Runza. B, Chislik. C, Puppy Chow. D, Chippers. E, Lefs. Answer. Trick question. They're all people food. 10. Which of these is a famous comic book villain? A, Ypsilanti. B, Knock 'em Stiff. C, Wauwatosa. D, Mixyelecipic. E, Ipswich. Answer. D. 11. When you remove your bratwurst from the freezer, you A, defrost it. B, thaw it. C, unthaw it. Answer, C. 12. When approaching a four-way stop, you A, roll and go. B, what stop sign? C, wave everyone by a minimum of 3 times each before finally proceeding. Answer, C. So how'd you do? Self-score and total your correct answers. 0 to 3 correct? Oh, this is the right book for you. 4 to 6 correct? Not bad, but there's still some work to be done. This is the right book for you. 7 to 9 correct? Impressive. You've clearly spent time here. This is the right book for you. 10 to 11 correct? You're a Heartland authority and you've almost perfected your casserole. This is the right book for you. Perfect 12. Eminent Midwesterner. This is the right book for you. The basics. The states of the Midwest. Before you learn how to fillet a walleye or call a loner without the right bower, let's first nail down where the heck we're even talking about. Illinois, Indiana, Iowa, Kansas, Michigan, Minnesota, Missouri, Nebraska, North Dakota, Ohio, South Dakota, and Wisconsin. In alphabetical order, so no one gets their feelings hurt, which is the last thing anyone wants to do in the Midwest. Each one of these 12 proud states lays an arguable claim to being the most Midwest. But how to ever resolve such a thing? Is it proximity to the Great Lakes? Snowfall volume and duration? Longest goodbye? Most corn? Most lakes? Most unnamed roads? Most crappies hooked? Most growlers purchased? Holiest fish fries? Best jerky? Most sacred church bar crawls? Biggest racks? The most pronounced "aw, you betcha" accent? Or strangely, the least pronounced, try to sound like you're from Dayton if you want to sound generic American and get a job in broadcasting accent? Should coordinates resolve this debate of the most Midwest? If we were a dartboard, hitting Cedar Rapids might get you 25 points, but don't write off everyone on the outskirts. Nebraska may sound like a stretch, but once you've driven past 8 billion acres of corn or scarfed down a Omaha Reuben, you might as well be in Indiana. And Cincinnati may teeter mere feet from the American South. But play euchre against one of their Westsiders and they'll win with offsuit nines and queens while finishing a case of Pabst like they worked the beer lines in Milwaukee. A wonderful hodgepodge of history, topography, weather, industry, location, community, and deer all combined in a way to create the American heartland out of these 12 states. And while these 12 may give each other guff every now and again, collectively they're a shared experience in everything from the way we raise our kids to the cheese on our pie. Why is the Midwest so close to New Jersey? Before deciding where the Midwest is, or should be, we should first figure out the location of dead center USA. Since 1918, a town called Lebanon, Kansas, has laid claim to being the geographic center of the United States. The scientists at that time used a rather sophisticated technology to reach this important conclusion. They cut out a cardboard map and balanced it on a nail. I shoot you not. When the board achieved perfect balance on the nail, they knew they'd found dead center USA, Lebanon. When Alaska was added, dead center moved 500 miles west to Belle Fouche, South Dakota. In any case, during the American Revolution, Cleveland, Ohio was considered the Wild West to colonials. Fort Wayne, Indiana was an actual fort. Guys dared their drunk friends to cross the Ohio River. Only the bravest, deranged, and desperate folk in the colonies watched the sun set behind Pittsburgh and thought, huh, I wonder what's out that way. Ohio, Indiana, Iowa, Michigan, Minnesota, Missouri, and so on were the West, a catch-all term for all those woods and open plains that Americans of European descent often kept away from, but talked about with a strange combination of disinterest and yearning that continues to this day. 100 years later, there were another 40 states, and the West had moved 2,000 miles and into the Pacific.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.